Welcome to episode 1 of my new series where I rank every Geometry Dash coin on a tier list. This is the first episode where we will go over the first 5 levels. And a special shout out to GD Cullen for inspiring this video. I think it's nice how relaxed the first coin is in the game. It not just introduces fake walls, but also shows you 2 possible ways. You could either drop in at one point and then do a late jump, or just fall. It's a nice coin, and I think it's worthy of a B. The second coin relies on a part you could actually use to help you instead of kill you before 1.6 when coins were added. And you actually get to do some kind of gameplay as it goes on with the extra spike. A. The third coin's insane. You see a small opening in the wall in your first run and you're like, I wonder if that actually does anything. And then what you get in, it's a whole alternate ending with increased difficulty on the original rocket scene. Anyways, please welcome our first S tier. Gravity changing has not been introduced to the game yet they decided to use that for this first coin and back on track. The focus of the level is the yellow jump pad, so why are we using a blue one? And these 2 other things annoy me. It's auto and that portal is upside down. The way I see it, I'm giving it a C. This feels like a copypasta of Stereo Madness's first coin, but with the spaceship instead of the cube. Could have been an A if it had like a little bit more difficulty to it. But for now, it's going to be a B. The third coin is so much better. You literally get to go under the level and still play it the same way, and it also focuses on the level's main thing, the yellow jump pad. It's tempting and satisfying, and I think it's worthy of an S tier. First coin in Polar Guy sucks! The coin encourages you to hug the ceiling, which makes it way too easy compared to what you could be doing in the game, and it's just insanely stupid. That's an F. Poltergeist's second coin, however, is just pretty much the same as Back on Track's third coin, except it also focuses on the level's main mechanic, the orb. However, I feel like the plagiarism brings it down a little bit to C. Again, with the blue jump pad, hasn't been introduced, nor has gravity changing. And also, the introduction of blind jumps. I feel like it's a little too harsh on the players, but I'll still give it a D. Speaking of D, dry out. You legit have no idea that the coin is there unless you just so happen to drop in, but then again you have to start holding or else you'd die. F. Now the second one is insanely cool compared to that first one. You have to like realize, yep, that jump is possible, and then you jump and get your coin. But you can't just hold or else you'll jump right into the spikes. This is a really cool coin and it's worthy of an A. This next coin's gotta be one of the most tempting in the game. You could either go the really big route that most people take or the really small route that you basically have to straight fly to go through. Minus that it's really far into the level, the rest of it's phenomenal, and I think it's worthy of, once again, S. Base after base. Oof, this coin sucks. First up, the way you go in just looks super ugly. And 2, it's auto. That's an F. The second coin shares a similar flaw to the dryout one, however, it's a little bit more cool and a little bit more creative. This time, gravity portals have actually been introduced, and then it can feel like you messed it up, but then in reality you're like, oh, I just found a coin, and it's pretty satisfying to feel. But it could be much better, so my final grade is a D. The third coin is indeed another F. I mean, come on, you're literally skipping the gameplay and just holding. I'd much rather actually get to play the level a little bit. See you in part 2 where we go over Can't Let Go, Jumper, Time Machine, Cycles, and X-Step. See ya.